My name's Tony Murrell. I joined the school in 1961. We were the first pupils here. I came from Pangbourne Primary School, which they shut down, and they sent 10 or 12 of us to Little Heath, where we had two members of staff to look after us. That lasted probably 2 years until 63, when the school was properly opened and a whole year came in.
I'm Imogen and I joined in September 2022 and I'm in year seven. And this is my granddad, Tony.
I joined the school, as I said, in 61, and for 2 years we only had two members of staff, a Mr. Malcolm and a lady, I can't remember her name. And we also shared lessons with Phil Green, who were in the same boat. They only had a few pupils, and they were halfway through being built as well. And they used to come up here sometimes. We did games with them because there wasn't enough really of us to have games. I can remember most of my lessons and where I was, but I'm afraid it's all changed. Well, I like woodwork and I like we had tech drawing and woodwork and things like that I liked. We did most of the lessons which were available, but there was only with just two members of staff, because only being 10 or 12 to us. During the first 2 years, we ended up with probably about 24 in the class. People moved in around here, and there was a couple of children who left other schools and came here. We ended up with about 24 before 1963, when it was properly opened. Fantastic. Yeah, we got away with murder because there's no one here to look after us, really, and we just did what we wanted. We built that go-kart in that room. We built a go-kart. He said we got a kit, and some of the parents gave us some bits, and we built a go-kart, and we used to drive around the roads here in the afternoon, disturbing everybody in all the houses around it, because it made a lot of noise. And we didn't have a lot of lessons. We had a few, but I can't remember many until 63, when they got all the staff came in and we mingled. Even then it was difficult because we were 2 years older than the first year it came in, proper. And I think there was about 100 or so of them, I think, the first year they came in. And we had 26, as I said, in our class, and that's all there was. We could do games with them, and that was about the lot. Yeah, we got caned on the hands. That was all. Wasn't the end of the world. We got caned, if you want to know that, when we were prefects in the first year, and it was very, very cold that winter, I remember, and the cloakrooms were at the front of the school. And we used to charge the kids to come in and warm their hands on the radiators for sixpence, with 2.5p as it is now. And we got into trouble for that. They weren't keen on us taking money. Some of the parents complained that we were taking money off for these little poor little first years for warming their hands on the radiators when it was very cold at the playtime and lunch. That one's a set, not too bad.
Not good. Be terrified now and have to stand up and do it in front of everybody. You get detentions or same day sanctions, or if you're really bad, then you get a heads DT.
You don't do metalwork or anything like that, do you?
Next year we do metalwork.
You do metalwork?
Now we do woodwork.
Yeah, I did woodwork.
Textiles.
I still, up to about 2 or 3 years ago, I still had my table. We had to, in tech drawing, it was called, we had to design something and for O levels and make it in woodwork, make the actual thing. And we had people come round here, the examiners came round and saw them and marked us on them. And I made a member of table with a magazine rack at one end in wood, and it took me ages and ages, lots of work, but I was really keen on that. I quite enjoyed woodwork.
Probably the punishments, like
the what
punishments.
Punishment, yeah. Well, that's like, probably a good idea, really. But there again, if you don't, you've got to punish them so it affects them, so you just do it again. But you probably, physical punishment is not a good idea. There's probably lots of other things you can do apart from physical. I don't know what other schools do nowadays. We had a boy here, Danny Robinson, who won. He was absolutely amazing. He was in the A team trials at Reading football. He also amazing at cross country. He won. I went to watch him in Wantage in the county cross country, and he won it by about half a mile. And he went at Prospect Park or Palmer Park, one of them, as a running track. They did the mile. And he won. He started lapping people in the mile, and it was only what, 4 or 5 laps or so, and he was lapping people. He came second in the national cross country in Scotland. He went for it or something. The UK one, he came second in that, and he came second because the bloke who won it shoved him into. He said shoved him into a barbed wire fence, so they're running around together.
Yeah, I was in the same house as him.
Yeah, the same. The houses are still the same. Well, they were. It was Conway, Warwick, Stirling, Arundel, which I went to. I went to Arundel, and I've been to Conway, and I've been to Warwick, and the only one I haven't been to is Stirling. And I was Stirling. Best part about being Little Heath? Well, that was probably the freedom we had for the first 2 years, I'm afraid. And all the things, but I did like later on doing all the games and all the competitive. I'm very competitive. I've been a tennis coach for since the 70s, mid 70s, and I've coached hundreds of children and played tennis all my life. I've just finished playing over 70s county. And so that side of it, I used to like all the games. I'm afraid games and other practical things in lessons.
Like my favourite lessons, and then having like different people with different classes, so you have like a variety of different things that you can do.